Developed by Massive Entertainment and released in 2016, Tom Clancy's The Division was the first game to use the Snowdrop engine. Among other graphical marvels, The Division has a visual effect that really stands out from the rest, and that is the echo recordings. So, how do we implement this effect in Unity? First, we need a way of authoring these scenes. You can use some existing tools in order to create point clouds from existing meshes. Export that scene into your preferred 3D software and edit as you like. Unfortunately, it will be a bit tricky to get the information that we need using pre-existing tools. We assume that the people at Massive Entertainment probably put some effort into creating some kind of tool that allowed artists to create these scenes. In our case, since we are using Unity, we will extend the editor to create this tool inside Unity. We don't want to get into much detail here, the code will be available on GitHub if you want to see how this tool works, but the general idea is to raycast multiple rays within a radius using the surface direction that is hitting the center of the cursor. We can tweak the radius and number of points created from the cursor. Clicking Save will save the mesh containing all points of the echo inside the echo data file, which is basically a scriptable object. Bear in mind that for this tool to work, all your meshes will need a mesh collider so the rays can collide with them. We can also tweak the light direction, which would give artists an extra tool for fine-tuning the mood of the scenes. With our data ready, now we have to find a way to render that information. For this, we have created a component called Echo Renderer, which is simply going to call graphics draw mesh on update using a material that we are about to create. This material, called Echo in our project, is going to use a shader that, for now, is simply going to take the vertex position, transform it to clip space, and set the color of the pixel to a color property that we have defined in the material. In order to apply some lighting, we use the lighting direction property, which we will inject later from our echo data, and calculate some simple lambda lighting. Now, we can finally set this material on the component and inject the lighting direction to the shader, and voila, we have rendered our echo scene. The next step is to apply some interaction to the shader. In The Division, when the player overlaps with some echo data, the points get pushed away. For this, we have used another component called Echo Interactor, which will then be passed into the material. In the shader, we simply push the point position depending on the distance to the interactor. This, along with some randomization, will achieve a similar result to the original effect. There is a problem though. In The Division, the effect is combined with a bunch of post-process effects. The scene gets dark, blue, and blurry. If we use a post-process volume around the scene, when all the effects kick in, the echo will get lost because these effects will overlay the scene. The solution is to render all these echoes to a separate texture and mix the main render with the echo texture in a new post-process effect, at which point we will also add some glitchy effects. To achieve this, every echo renderer will register itself to an echo manager on enable. Then we will create a post-process effect that will get all the echo renderers registered on the manager and will add their draw calls to a common buffer, which will then be rendered with a new shader after the post-process stack is applied. In order to create the glitchy effect, we generate some bands using time and sine functions, getting something like this, this, and this, and then we use some black math magic with diabolic numbers and we get something that looks glitchy. This new shader will also have an opacity parameter that will blend if we go from a post-process volume to another volume. We use this opacity value to make the echoes appear and disappear with more black magic. We can also add a draw call on draw gizmos, which will make the effect visible on the editor, improving the workflow for artists and level designers. Giving it some final touches and stealing some sound effects from the original game, this is how it looks like.
Active echo beacon detected.
All the code will be available on GitHub, so if you're interested, find the link in the description below. Remember to like, subscribe, and leave a comment with which game effect you would like to see next. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.